We could start the first question. Last night, Da Zhuang was asking about Sammasangappa. He wondered what the reality is. And we briefly mentioned about Vitakka. So he was not clear about Vitakka and Jetana.
Es vitakka, rupa, achitta.
今天的问题是正思维是寻心所，那是什么意思？老师第一个是反问，这个寻心所是设法吗？还是是心？
It arises with almost every citta. This is to be understood too, to really understand what it is.
那么寻心所呢？它几乎是跟每一刻的心几乎都有它哦。
What appears are not those who arise together, but they do not appear.
嗯哼，那么每一刻都有很多的法的出现哦，那它并没有出现。
Even citta is not easy to understand the nature of it as nothing and no one. It's only the reality which no one can stop its arising because there are conditions for its arising just to arise to experience an object.
嗯哼，那么即使我们并不知道法并不是人东西哦，但是我们现在是不知道的，但是我们不可能阻止法的升起。
So now, what?Experiences an object.
所以现在呢，是什么在经验一个对象？
There is the idea of I see and I hear and I think and so on in life.
那么我们都会认为有个想法是我在看，我在听，我在想。
And what is the absolute truth even just at this very moment now? So many things are known.
那么即使是现在这一刻，它的绝对的真相是什么？有这么多是不被知道的。
That's why Buddha taught about the truth of each reality as it is, only when it appears to be known, even there and there now. For example, vitakka and jetana and so on, but they do not appear.
所以佛陀的教导呢，是都教了哦，可是像寻心所、思心所。他们升起，但是并没有出现哦。
In order to understand the truth of what is there, are only many different realities conditioned to arise, to appear, and then gone unknowingly, because each moment subsists, one moment at a time, very rapidly.
嗯，那么每一刻呢，都有许多的法彼此因缘资助升起哦，然后因为他们很快的就灭了。然后我们并不知道这些事情。
So study the meaning of each word that Buddha said from his enlightenment. Even right now, he taught about seeing because there is seeing. So he taught about what seeing is.
嗯哼，那比如现在是不是有在看？所以佛陀有告诉我们，教导我们那个看是什么。
It has a reason.No one can make it arise at all because it's there already. But the nature of that which experiences is not known. So whatever arises and experiences are clung to be I who experience that.
那么眼识的升起呢是有原因的，没有谁可以要它升起或不要它升起。但是它所有的心都是去经验哦，但是这件事情我们现在并不知道，所以我们会觉得是我在经验。
And from birth and also other lives in the past eons and years, there must be hearing, seeing, but no understanding of their nature at all.
那么在过去是在无数世以来呢，都有眼识在看，都有在看，但是那个在看的并没有被了解。
As now.Is there any understanding of seeing which sees all the time right now?
就像现在啊，一直好像是不是在看，但是都不知道它的真相。
By his enlightenment, Buddha realized the truth, which is so very deep and so subtle, and just taught the truth for the other to begin to consider the truth, to understand the truth of that which hasn't been realized. from years and years ago that can be learned little by little.
那么佛陀体证的真相是什么呢？ 虽然它非常的深奥，就是它是有可能一点一点的慢慢累积去了解的， 所以它是有教导我们真相是什么。
So now, I've been thinking about Vitakka, or what is that which sees? Then we can talk about Vitakka later.
我们当然可以讨论寻心所是什么， 但是现在我们是想要知道寻心所， 但是有更重要的， 现在那个去经验的， 比如说那个在看的是什么。
So, no matter how much we think about it, but when it does appear, it couldn't be realized. But only that which is now appearing can be object of studying, learning to understand its nature little by little.
因为呢, 如果它没有出现, 它就不可能成为被了解的对象。 所以我们当然可以讨论寻心所, 但是现在在看或在听是有出现的, 它是有机会被了解的。
Because they're seeing right now, but there are other realities together, but they do not appear. So learn to understand seeing in order to understand that which do not appear now.
所以现在呢, 比如说在看的时候呢, 不只是掩饰而已, 还有其他的法, 但是其他的, 比如说那七个心所并没有出现哦, 所以我们学着知道什么是心, 那么逐渐的可以知道其他的法。
Beginning to, now is there. What is it? It's that which sees. What is there appearing? It's the object which is seen. Without that reality which sees it, it cannot appear at all.
那么现在一定有什么被看到吗? 那如果没有那个在看的去经验它, 有可能有任何东西被看到吗?
But what are there? They are not just seeing alone, but there are other reality, but they do not appear. So now it's time to understand what is there in order to understand all that which can experience an object too.
但是我们刚刚讲的这些呢, 其实它的真相都没有被知道哦, 所以现在是时候了, 该是逐渐的慢慢的去了解它们是什么。
What is seen is experience. To that which arises to be the chief of experiencing it.
那个是什么? 那个去经验的那个带着头, 那个首领去经验的是什么?
When that is not seen, it's impossible to talk about it. For example, what color is there? What thing is there? What shape is there? When it does not appear, no one can tell.
如果掩饰没有升起, 谁能够知道那个是什么颜色, 那个是什么形状呢?
But the truth is that if it's not be the object of the experiencing, the nature of it, that which can impinge on the eyes, can anyone understand it as it is?
那么如果没有那个去撞击眼根的那个法, 如果从来没有这个法撞击眼根被看到了, 那这个可以被 了解吗?
Usually, that which is appearance is known, but to be something, it doesn't matter because it's there to be experienced, but that which experiences each moment of what of that which is now appearing as something are not known at all.
那么通常呢, 那个被经验的, 不管是现在出现的都是人或者是东西哦, 这是没关系, 但是那个去经验的呢, 那个去经验的有被了解吗?
So now it's time to consider carefully about the nature which is the chief of experiencing. Anytime it's there, experience an object. That's why it can be known as that which is the chief of experiences the object, while there are other reality arising with it too.
所以呢, 现在是时候开始去了解那个去经验的,那个主要的去经验的, 那当然还有其他的法一起协助他经验, 但是我们都还不知道那个主要的去经验的是什么。
So, it's time to begin to develop, to understand the truth. There must be a reality which arises and experiences an object.
Ajahn, say that again, sorry.
So now it's time to develop the understanding of that which arises to experience an object.
所以现在是时候去建立那个身体，去经验一个所缘的那个法了。
Not just talk about it and think that there is the understanding of it, but actually, it just heard about it, but not the moment of developing the understanding of the nature, which now no one, but it arises, so it experiences an object.
那么不是只是在文字上说讨论，然后认为自己已经了解那个法了，而是真的去了解它的无我的本质，它的身体只是去经验一个对象而已。
So begin to have no doubt about seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching, because it's so natural in a day. And also there is thinking, not just seeing, hearing, smelling, and tasting, touching.
所以现在是时候去了解那个在看、在听、在闻、在尝、在碰触的，当然还有那个去思考的。
So what is there, which is not seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching? We could say that it's the moment of thinking.
那么所以当没有在看、在听、在碰触闻的时候呢，是什么？是在想，在思考。
How seeing is different from hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching.
以及那个在看的，它是如何的跟在听、在闻、在尝、在碰是不一样的。
This is the development of understanding the truth of that which is now appearing, little by little, by one's own considering, to that which is like question, but no thought about it before, but what is the difference between seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching?
那么，这些呢，之前其实都没有去想过，可是我们真的懂吗？那个在看的跟在听的是怎么样的不同？
Is there any answer?
有没有回答呢？ 大壮，比如在看跟在听的有什么不同？
Would you like to develop considering the truth of what is the difference between seeing and hearing, smelling, tasting, touching?
那么会想要建立思慧的培养思慧吗？ 所以那个在看的跟在听闻尝碰有什么不一样？ ？大壮，你要不要说看看？
我就是听老师讲了这个，就在当下能够感受到一点那种，乏味吧，就是说有那种感觉，理解那些法都是在自然的，随着因缘在这个流动在生灭的感觉，有这种就是说它是一种自然的，并没有一个真正的有谁在这个。 控制啊，操控啊，这样子。
Dazhong has a comment about hearing what Ajahn just explained for the past few minutes. There is a sense of there are just dhammas arising and passing by condition. There's no one there. There's a sense of just dhamma out there.
The same as seeing, smelling, tasting, touching. But what is the difference between seeing and hearing?
那么老师的问题呢是，那再看呢，它跟听闻尝有什么不一样？比如说，看的跟听的有什么不一样？
This is wise considering to understand just one word and understand what does it mean and consider the meaning of it. What is the difference between seeing and hearing?
Yeah. 一样哦，大壮，他们的不同在哪？在什么？在看，在听？你可以回答吗？安西。
他们就是不同的地方发生，不同的这个条件，在一起，就是有不同的这个，就是所谓的功能这个出现。
Dr. John mentioned three differences. They have different functions. They arise at different space, and they have different conditions to arise.
That's it. So no one there at all. This is the beginning to develop the very firm confidence of no self from whatever is heard to understand better and better. Even it is the chief of experiencing when it arises. The reality which can experience, which arise together, cannot be the chief of experience, the characteristic of the object which appears, but only citta. That's why it's different from the other mental factors.
那么首先呢，这个回答是没错哈，这是我们开始去真的越来越去有信心、坚定的了解，并没有人在那里哦。好，那么去经验的呢，其他的心所都不是那个主要的去经验的，他们不能像心一样那样子。那么心，我们要先知道心就是。就只是去经验一个对象而已。
And this is the path leading to understand what is that which has been covered up years and years ago, to just begin to understand a little firmer about that which is there, is conditioned to arise, to experience, and then gone instantly. So it cannot be taken for anyone or anything at all.
这也是过去是这么久累世以来呢，我们其实很少累积的、哦、就是我们很少去累积，有这个机会累积真相，是只是放在那里，并没有人，没有东西、哦、
At moment of seeing, just seeing, just seeing, is there any other reality besides the seven jitasikas?
那么在看的那一刻呢？就只是那个在看的，他就在看而已。那么除了眼识之外呢，还有那七个心所，还有没有别的法
？To understand different moment of life now，
这样是为了去了解每一个所谓的生命呢，在不同的时刻的生命是什么
？Why only ten citta has only？Seven jitasikas arising with it.
为什么只有双五识是七个心所而已？其他的心都超过七个。
If there is no understanding of these ten, how can there be the understanding of vitakka jitasika?
如果不能够了解这个双五识呢，又怎么能够进一步的去了解什么是寻心所？
So no doubt about the seven jitasikas as factors of seeing moment.
所以，关于在看的那一刻呢，我们对于那七个心所有没有怀疑呢
？Otherwise, there cannot be the understanding of difference between those jitas and the other jita which follow it.
否则我们当然就不能够更进一步的去了解心以及心之外的其他的法。
After seeing, experience of the object is gone.
那么眼识呢，在他经验完色尘之后，他就走了，过去了。
But each citta has to condition the next moment citta to arise. Only one citta which cannot.Condition any citta to arise after it, the jutti citta of arahata.
但是每个心虽然一升起就灭了、哦、它是下一个心可以再升起的因缘条件、哦、除了阿罗汉的死亡心。
And it can be understood right now. No one can stop the citta arising and falling away on and on and on.
那么它是可以被了解的，就是这些心跟心所一再的生灭，一再的生灭。
But each condition for each citta to arise is different too.
但是每一颗它升起的条件也是不一样的。
So when the seeing consciousness has fallen away, the next citta is conditioned by the seeing citta, and as the object hasn't fallen away yet, the object is there.
嗯哼，那么眼
follow the seeing, experience the same object, but it does not see.
嗯哼，那么在眼识它升起看到这个色尘之后呢，它灭了，它是下一个新升起的因缘条件。但是只有眼识能看哦，下一个心不管是哪一种类型的心，它既然不是眼识，它的功能就不是去看，即使是同一个色尘哦。
It arises to experience the same object as seeing, but it cannot see.
所以在演示之后呢，它也是身体，那个心也是身体去经验这个色尘，但是这个功能并不是去看哦。
So how can it experience the same object as seeing when it does not see?
那所以它要怎么样能够经验跟刚才灭去的演示同一个色尘？如果它是不能看的？因为演示之后那个心不能看，它怎么样经验同一个色尘
？Because there must be one mental factor which performs the function of vitakka, touch the object, but not see it.
这个时候就是为什么寻心所，它被说它的功能是去 touch, 去碰触那个所缘，因为演示之后那个心不能看，它是靠这个心所。
Pasa jetasika.Contacts the object to citta, but that is the only function of contact. Pasa just contact; it cannot do other thing at all.
嗯哼，那我们讲触心所呢？那个每一个七个心所骗一切心心所的触心所，它的功能只是去接触那个所缘，让心能够经验，没有别的功能的。
And seeing arises to see that which pasa is contacted by citta.
嗯哼，那么眼识为什么能够经验色尘？因为触心所触了色尘。
So it does perform the function of seeing, which is the result of karma in the past, to see the present object or unpresent object. No one knows, only by conditions.
嗯哼，那么这个。触心所触的是可喜或不可喜的对象呢，那是要看这个眼识它是来自过去的善善的业力还是不善的业力带来的结果。
So now, what is the absolute truth of that which Buddha had enlightened?
所以现在那个绝对的真相，也就是佛陀了解的开悟了的绝对真相是什么？
No one knows about the reality which is conditioned to arise with the other jetasika, but it performs a function of vitakka, not seeing but touch the object which is there.
那个绝对的真相呢，就是并不是有一个人在那里去经验哦，而只是法。比如说那个去看的，他是因为过去的业力带来的果报，他经验了某个色尘。那么他需要有其他的法去协助他，比如触心所去触这个色尘。
And the ekakata jetasika, this is the moment of one pointless to that very object as vitakka has touched.
嗯哼，那么还有一个叫做一境性的这个心所也会协助哦，它是专注，它是在触心所触的这个所缘呢，这个一境性呢。让心呢就专注专心去经验这个所缘，所以不会去有第二个所缘干扰。
That's why any citta which does not just arise to experience the object as seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching must have vitakka as its condition.
那么刚刚讲到双五识呢，刚刚是用眼识当例子哦，眼识它可以看到色尘，可是接下来那个心呢，它不能看哦。那还要怎么样经验同一个色尘？就是需要这个寻心所去碰触这一个所缘。
So what is the absolute truth of what is there now? The one moment of seeing, but many moments with vitakka to experience the same object as seeing right now.
所以现在其实就在发生这件事情了，在看的那一刻并没有寻心所，但是除了看这一刻以外的接下来的心呢，都需要寻心所。
Consider the citta with only 7 cittasikas and the other cittas which has more conditions to experience the same object as seeing.
所以这个是我们进一步去思维，除了双五识之外呢，其他的心呢，绝大多数的时刻都是需要这个寻心所的。
And this is the great difference of what appears is not that which is the truth of this very moment.
但是这是真正出现的，并不是这些法，而是有形状的人跟东西哦。这个是目前的真相并没有真的出现。
And the teachings about this truth is the work of the Buddha, the enlightened one, who has enlightened the truth of everything, even one citta and how many cittasikas arising at a time.
那么每一刻呢，是什么心？它为什么只有这几个心所？那比如说眼识为什么只有七个心所等等？这些是来自于佛陀的话。
If everything still be like when there's no understanding of the truth of each moment, the world cannot appear as it is, as arising and falling away instantly.
那么如果不是真的透过佛陀的话去了解真相呢？真正的世界是不会出现的，真正的世界是只有法而已。
So how much of the understanding to developTo let go that which covers up the truth, ignorance, and attachment.
所以需要多久的时间去累积多少智慧，才能够真的看穿这些无明贪爱的掩盖
？And beginning to understand what's meant by the subtlety of each reality which is now there.
这样才能开始慢慢去真的体会到为什么会说。在那里的法是这么的细微深啊。
In order to gradually eliminate the clinging and ignorance of what is now appearing as something.
因为这个对这个法的细微深奥的慢慢体会呢，也是代表着慢慢逐渐的放掉对有人有东西的执取哦。
And even the moment of thinking about it.It doesn't appear as what we heard.
那即使是我们思考着佛陀的话呢，也不代表现在的真相是有出现的，是了解的。
But without hearing and considering more, how can what is now appearing will appear as nothing and no one, little by little?
虽然思考他的话不见得真的有智慧升起哦，但是如果从来不去思考他的话，那怎么可能有机会去了解真相是什么？并没有人，没有东西。
So now, is there vitakka, cittasikka?
好，所以那现在呢，有没有寻心所
？And as Ajahn has mentioned, Da Zhuang, vitakka is one of those mental factors, cittasikkas that arises with almost every citta, but does not appear.
那状呢，就像老师刚刚提的，在每一刻呢，几乎都有寻心所，但是寻心所是没有出现的。
So in that sense, it's something of a mystery as to why it's included as one of the 8 mental factors of that make up the Eightfold Path.
所以它既然没有出现呢，那好像有点神秘哦。那它为什么被包括在？
From our point of view, we would expect, as you said, something more like jetana to be one of those factors.
那么就像你或者是很多人可能会以为，那个私心所那个意图才应该是八正道的其中一个啊。
But such line of thinking or speculation is not going to be helpful in coming to understand the meaning of the Buddha's teaching.
那有一些人呢，他可能会认为为什么不是正意图，而是正思维？那这样子的思考，为什么这个不在里面，那个不在里面？这样子并没有真的帮助正道的建立啊。
So many aspects of the teaching are so subtle that only when understanding has been more developed will their meaning become apparent.
那么佛陀的教导呢，有太多是太深了，只有当智慧累积到一定的程度，逐渐的才会那个教导才会开始真的懂是什么意思。
And in the meantime, there is no point in trying to assign a reason for the inclusion of something in a grouping or the exclusion of another factor. There's no point in trying to, in asking the question, why is this one factor and why isn't that a factor?
在我们目前这个阶段呢，去预测或者是推论到底什么该属于八正道，为什么没有，其实这个还不到时候。John, let me, sorry, let me interrupt a little bit. Initially, Da Zhuang was just wondering what does Samasankalpa mean? Mm-hmm. And when we explained the Vitakka, and then he thought about Jetana, what's the difference mm-hmm. between these two? So he was not really thinking about why Jetana is not part of the factor.
Right, okay, thanks.
Sorry, I was not clear.
No, that was exactly what you said at the time. But I suppose I'm just speaking generally anyway, but I'll go on to mention something about his question, the difference between the two. The difference between vitakka and jetana is that they perform different functions.
首先呢，我们来看寻心所跟思心所呢，它们有不同的功能。
So every mental factor performs a specific function that is makes it different from every other mental factor.
当然，每个心所它们有各自不同的功能特征，这就是为什么它们跟其他的心所是不一样的。
And as Ajahn has explained, the function of vitakka is to touch the object.
就像老师刚刚有解释到，寻心所的功能是去碰触。
And the function of jetana is, roughly speaking, to intend, but also to coordinate all the other mental factors that are arising together with it.
那思心所呢？它的功能基本上我们就是讲意图嘛。但是它也有一个所谓的去当班长哦，就是所有一起升起的心所，它是负责去统合他们执行功能的。
It is the mental factor of intention that constitutes karma.
那么当它是意图的时候呢，也就是我们说的业。
So.From that, one can appreciate that it's quite different from vitakka, which has the function just of touching the object.
所以从这个功能来看，它是非常不同于寻心所。寻心所是所谓的 touch 碰触那个所缘啊，但是意图思心所，它是业的时候，这是很大的不同。
And as Ajahn discussed, after seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching.All the other cheetahs, we're not talking about jhana now, but all the other cheetahs have to have vitakka, touching and experiencing the object.
那么像老师刚刚有解释哦，在双五识以外的心呢，除了几个少数的例外，包括禅定以外，那一定有寻心所。
So in the sense door process, no matter whether the cheetahs after seeing are vipaka, kiriya,Kusala or akusala, they all have to have vitakka to touch or mount the object in order for the citta to arise.
所以在双五识之后呢，接下来的各种不同的类型的心呢，包括善心或不善心，都一定需要这个寻心所去碰触这个所缘，帮助心让心升起的条件。
And in the mind or processes at each moment, of thinking, at each moment of understanding, vitakka has to be there, touching the object in order for the citta to experience it.
那么在意门呢，在意门的心路过程呢，寻心所一定在那里，寻心所必须碰触这个所缘，所以心才能够去思考这个所缘。
So when it comes to samasankappa of the path, it's always arising with understanding, without samasankappa, touching the object to be understood, the reality to be known now, understanding cannot understand it.
所以当我们讲正思维的时候呢，samasankappa这个寻心所呢，它碰触的对象是法，所以法可以成为心去经验智慧去了解的对象。
So now there is a beginning of understanding about different realities, but when it's not yet the direct understanding of those realities, even though vitakka is there at each of those moments of understanding, it's not the samasankappa of the Eightfold Path, which touches the object for understanding to directly understand, directly penetrate its nature.
但是像现在呢就有寻心所，对不对？但是这个寻心所，我们不能叫它叫做 samasankappa 的正思维哦，因为这个时候寻心所碰触的是它经验的是概念，但是当我们讲正思维的时候呢，它是直接经验法了，那是四念住了。
So it's a very important reality. Like when thinking now, sanya conditions the vitakka to touch different objects.That are thought about. So without vitakka, there wouldn't be thinking about anything at all.
所以这是一个非常角色蛮重要的一个法，因为他如果不去碰触任何对象，是不可能有思考这件事情发生的，因此它被翻译成思维哦。
Even in deep sleep, vitakka is touching the object that is experienced by the Bhavanga Cittas.In order for them to experience their unknown object.
那么除了眼耳鼻舌身意这六个根门以外呢的活动，在有分心，他经验过去世的所缘，一样也是有寻心所在碰触这个所缘，让心去经验。
So it plays its role, it has its function at every moment other than seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching.No matter whether the cittas are kusala or akusala, with understanding, without understanding, and other vipaka cittas, like after seeing and hearing and so on, other vipaka cittas must have vitakka in order to experience the object, and so on.
那这就是为什么除了双五识以外呢，其他的类型的心，不管是不是果报心啊，不管是善心不善心，或刚刚讲到的有分心，除了双五识以外，需要这个寻心所去碰触这个所缘，才能够心才能去经验它。
And as Jonathan said, chetana arises at every moment of every citta and has different function to vitakka, like at the moment of seeing now or hearing now. Without chetana coordinating the citta seekers that arise with seeing.There couldn't be any experience of the object.
但是跟思心所有一个很大的差别哦，思心所是不管什么类型的心，它的功能一定就是统合所有的心所，去协助心去经验哦。所以如果没有思心所呢，眼识升起呢，那些其他的心所就不会执行它的功能。
And it has this function at every moment in life, but in addition.At moments of kusala and akusala, it wills to do, it wills to experience with kusala or akusala jitas.
就是在塑形心的时候呢，这个思心所又多了一个功能，就是我们刚讲的意图，就是业啊，它有一个所谓的意志力，我们以为的我的意志力其实是这个心所。
There is the intention at that moment. And when it's strong enough, then there can be the result of karma later on.
那么这个意图呢，每一刻都有在塑形心的时候，那如果它很强的时候呢，它就会成为造业的，在未来带来果报的一个动机来源。
But it can never be an eightfold path factor.
但是它不会是正道的因素，不是我有意志力要培养正道就可以的。
Some people think that understanding and the other path factors depend on Chaitanya intending to be aware, intending to understand, but this is not right.
有些人可能会以为正道的培养需要有一个意志力，我想要去了解，我想要培养正道，但这不是哦，它不是一个必须要有，而且它不需要这个。
Samasankappa is not intention, it is not Chaitanya, it arises by conditions, not by anyone's will or trying to develop understanding.
那么它跟那个正思维不一样哦，正思维是需要这个法去碰触那个出现的法才能直接经验，那刚刚即使是意图而升起，但是并不是靠意图就可以培养正道的。
So the point of considering is just to understand that these different factors, such as vitaka or chaitana, arise by their own conditions. In the case of chaitana, at every moment in life, vitaka at almost every moment in life, performing their function and making it possible for the citta to experience the object.
那么所以呢，思心所是每一刻的生命都有这个法，那寻心所是几乎都有，除了双五是在看在听以外，那么这些法是必须要的，否则心是没有办法去经验的。
Like you said about the difference between seeing and hearing, they have different functions. They arise by different conditions and experience the object clearly in a different way because of their different functions and conditions for arising.
就像刚才提到在看跟在听的眼识耳识的不同哦，他们的升起呢是有不同的条件的，那他们有不同的功能，但是他们就是去经验一个对象非常的清楚，所以眼是可以看得清楚，耳是听得清楚。
And it's the same with Vitaka and Chaitanya or any other Chaitasikas. They have their particular functions, their particular characteristics, their particular proximate causes and arise by conditions, perform those functions and fall away instantly.
那么所以刚刚提到的思心所跟寻心所也是一样哦，他们的升起一定也有他们的因缘条件。那比如说不管善或不善的意图，但是他们一样升起就灭了。
No one can decide or will or imagine what object Vitaka is going to touch or experience right now.
现在呢，没有人可以透过意志力或者可以决定那个寻心所要碰触哪一个所缘。
Just like no one can imagine what seeing will see right now or hearing will hear right now. And this is the subtlety of Dhamma, the beginning of understanding that whatever reality we are talking about, it is anatta, arising by its conditions and falling away instantly, not belonging to anyone.
就像现在没有人可以决定那个果报的演示，它的果报业报经验什么色尘。那个果报的耳是要经验什么声音？现在没有人可以决定了。
Any more questions or points on this topic, Dajun?
大壮，或者是其他的朋友，有没有什么问题呢？
谢谢，谢谢 Zara， 谢谢老师。那个就是刚才讲那个思维，就是那个寻心所，那个。八正道里面的正思维也是指的这个寻心所是吧？好的好的，谢谢。就是说这些讲的这些我是能够有感受啊，就是说 这些一定是因为只有固比有的原因，它形成了这样一些机制在里面，这个在运转运作。事先并没有一个什么是主宰的东西在那里，导致这样那样的发生。它就是因为形成了这样原因，导致那样那样，导致那样形成，产生出这些所谓的生命呢、啊，或者非生命的、啊、功能呢、啊，就是这样子，嗯。
Dazhong was actually just sharing his appreciation about vitakka is about touching or thinking, so the citta can think about, or the nama can think about. And then he mentioned about the dhamma are conditioned. There's really no one there to decide. So he was not asking questions. He just shared what.
And even when we say, or it's commonly said that vitakka is thinking, we have to consider what it's meant because it's not thinking in a conventional sense as we're used to. For example, the vipaka-citta straight after seeing in the sense door process have to be accompanied by vitakka, but is it thinking at that moment?
那么这里比较稍微要思考一下，就是我们把它翻成正思维，我们把寻心所有时候翻译成思考哦。但是，比如说在演示之后的领受推度，他们一样也有寻心所。可是，在五个根本里面的这些寻心所，他们真的有在思考吗？所以这里讲的思考跟我们传统上讲的思考是不一样的意思。
So there is just the touching of the object at those moments by the vipaka-cittas, which need vitakka in order to experience the object.
所以在经典里面，对它的精准的定义是碰触或者投向一个所缘哦，所以这就是那，所以才会有思考这件事情。
And even in the mind door, when we think of thinking, like we think of thinking about the names of our friends now, but actually the citta and vitakka arises and falls away instantly. So it's not like the conventional idea of thinking.
那么，即使在意门，当我们讲意门在思考的时候呢，寻心所在那里，但是并不是这一个单独的法就可以思考，一定是心啊、心所还有其他没有，比如说想运啊，要很多一起。那它每一刻就在生灭哦，所以它跟我们传统讲的这种我在想一个朋友的名字啊，这些等等是不太一样的。
So the more we consider, the more we appreciate how subtle the teachings are and how the different dhammas arise by their conditions and fall away in just such a very brief split second.
那么这也是为什么我们说法是很细微深奥的，我们要一直去确认这个每个法它的精准的定义、它的功能哦。那么我们也会慢慢的能够了解它跟传统上讲的是不太一样的。Another question is a friend. He was very new to the teaching, so he was wondering. He was just asking about he want to reduce, have less moha. And more calmness. That's what he wants. He is looking for that. So he was asking how. 这个问题呢，是有一个朋友呢，我在过年期间我跟他分享了佛法，那他之前并不是很熟，但是他其实心里面想要的是少一点无明，多一点平静，所以他在问说怎么样才可以多一点平静，少一点无明。
So the only way there will ever be less moha is if understanding develops. But can anyone make understanding arise? Can anyone make calm arise? Or it has to arise by the right conditions?
这件事情呢，要让无明减少，唯一只有智慧哦，正确的了解真相。那但是谁能让智慧升起呢？谁能让无明减少？谁能够让平静升起呢？
And without realizing it, when the aim is to have less ignorance and more calm, more kusala, less akusala, without knowing it, there is that strong clinging to oneself, wishing to be the person with more calm, wishing to be the person with more understanding. And this is the real hindrance to the development of understanding.
我不能够知道其实是智慧的功能, 而且这些法都是无我的。 如果不能够深深的知道这些事情, 那么想要有比较少的无明, 想要多一点的平静, 它的背后是有一个贪爱的, 执取, 对我的执取, 希望我有更多的平静, 我有更少的无明。
Because understanding develops when there is less and less clinging to the idea of self. So if there is clinging now, clinging to my personality or I being more calm, for example, then it's the wrong path. It's not the understanding that leads to letting go and being content with whatever appears now, whatever is experienced right now.
不是因为对现在正在出现的其实只是法的这样子的正确了解，那么就不可能降低减少对我的执取。 那么如果不能降低对我的执取，那些想要什么，其实是要为了我，我的个性，或者是怎么样，就是为了我要得到什么，这是错误的道路哦。When
there's clinging to what has just been experienced or what one hopes will be experienced in the future, it's not the understanding of what appears right now. It's not the understanding that life just exists in a moment now.
如果对现在在经验的对象是有执取的，如果对未来想要经验什么是有执取的，那个是没有了解真相是什么。现在这一刻真相是什么？So
hearing about the different realities, beginning to understand seeing and hearing different realities we've discussed as anatta, not in anyone's control. This is the way that understanding begins to develop. On and on, without thinking or minding about how much or how little understanding there is, how much or how little ignorance is, whether I have calm now or not.
那么，我们讨论眼识、耳识以及其他的法，这是开始去培养智慧的条件哦。那当然，最重要的是他们是不是我的嘛？那。 也只有这样子正确的培养智慧，而且不去介意，因为智慧不会去介意说我智慧培养的快或不快啊，或者是我现在有没有平静，智慧不会去介意的。So
the development of the path is not for me, not for me to have this or that, but just for the sake of understanding what appears now, what is real at this very moment.
对正道的培养呢非常重要，并不是为了我有正道，我在正道上，而只是去了解现在的真相是什么。可以吗？很多人其实是在追求平静哦，但是就掉入了我的平静的陷阱里。刘源，这个我特别提你，是因为我觉得你很在乎平静。
我曾经好像是，但我现在没有这种执着了。OK，
所以 Yuan just comment, she used to be like that, but now she is not obsessed with having calm.
就是最早年间去禅修的目的之一，可能是想要那种平静。
And that's probably wanting to have calm is the motivation to go to retreat before.
现在没有了。
But now it's not like that now.
And life is easier, right? Without that strong clinging, trying to get more and more calm for oneself, which actually just leads to more and more clinging and agitation, the opposite of what one would like.
Mm-hmm. 所以这样子生命是不是变得比较轻松呢？如果不去，一定要有平静，因为一直一定执取于平静，一定要多一点平静，这件事情本身是刚好相反的哦。
being contented with what's conditioned now.
就是现在的法，只有透过这样子才会真正有培养平静的最深的条件哦。
I think we're all inclined to think of calm as being the friend of understanding and the lack of calm as being the enemy of understanding. But that's not a helpful way of thinking about things.
我们通常会以为呢，平静是智慧的朋友，那么不平静的时候呢，是培养智慧的敌人哦。这不是正确的一个培养智慧的了解。
Think of calm as being the best condition for understanding to arise because there can be some kind of focusing on the object.
因为会以为呢，平静是智慧升起的最好的条件，因为在平静的时候呢，可以更专注，更就是聚焦在这个对象上。
But that was before we came to understand more about the conditioned nature of realities.As Ajahn has helped us to understand.
但会这么认为呢，是在我们真正知道法的因缘的生灭的本质，有些老师帮助我们去了解的这些因缘生灭的本质哦。
And the more we understand about the conditioned nature of realities, the more we appreciate that the best condition.For understanding to arise is firstly the having developed understanding in the past, and secondly, having heard the Buddha's explanation of the way things are in truth and reality.
是佛陀的教导呢，我们开始去真正了解的时候呢，智慧升起的。最重要的因缘条件并不是我们以前以为的平静哦，而是第一个是过去累积的智慧，第二个是能够听到佛陀的教导。
And having reflected on what we've heard, because the Buddha explained that there can be understanding of any reality that is appearing at the present moment.
所以也就是什么教导呢？就是智慧的培养必须是现在。能不能去了解现在出现的法，它的真相是什么
？And realities as mundane as seeing an invisible object are to be understood, need to be understood, in order for panya to continue to develop.
嗯，也就是说，在我们现在人世间俗世里面的在看有什么被看到，被看到的是什么，这些必须要被了解，智慧才能持续的累积哦。
And these realities are likely to be apparent much of the time, unlike some of the mental states that we may tend to be more concerned about, some of the subtle kilesas that we may think need to be dealt with. But that way of approaching the Dhamma is not helpful.
所以，我们刚刚提到的眼识跟那个被看到的，它现在其实是正在生灭、正在出现的。所以，去了解这件事情呢，它会比去想着那些比较细微的、并没有出现的法来更有帮助。
And I know that Yuan has come to appreciate that.Calm is not the all-important factor that she once thought it was.
那么这样说呢，他也可以看得出啊，刘元已经不再像以前那样认为平静是智慧升起的一个很重要的因素了。刘元，你有没有要说什么？
好像没有，没有。
就是你不再认为平静是智慧升起来的一个很重要的因素了吗？
对，
okay.
不再认为了。
She agreed that calm is not the very important factor, a condition for banya. 他们会一起升起哦，但是它并不是他的助缘哦，不是一个很重要的助缘啊，不是关键的。Ajahn, is there any words you would like to add?
Maybe consider the question a little more about, does anyone want to have less ignorance and more calm?
所以我们要再去思考一下这个问题啊， 有谁想要有更多的平静，然后少一点的无明吗？
To be truthful, does anyone want to have less ignorance and have more calm?
所以我们很诚实哦， 有没有人想要多一点平静，少一点无明？ 我们很诚实地问自己。
In order to have less ignorance, is there ignorance now?
为了要有比较少的无明，那么现在呢，有没有无明？
So, would like to have less ignorance of what?
所以我们要有更少的无明，是对什么有更少的无明？
If there is no understanding of what is ignorance, how can there be less ignorance?
如果从来不了解什么是无明，怎么可能会更少？
So, there must be the understanding of what is it first to understand whether there is the understanding, the benefit of have less ignorance.
所以要有更少无明之前呢，一定要有智慧去了解，有更少的无明的好处利益到底是什么？
At moment of having food, lunch or breakfast, is there any moment of wanting to have less ignorance?
那么在吃美味的早餐或午餐的时候，那个时候有想要有更少的无明吗？
So we just talk about the words as we talk about something as usual. Just want this and doesn't want that. But in truth, what is that which one doesn't want to have it more?
对，我们就像累积的习性就会总是要这个或要那个。 但是那个我们不想要有更多的到底是什么？
And what moment is calm so that one wants to have more calm?
那什么样的时刻是有平静的呢？ 什么样的状态我们可以说它是平静的？ 所以然后我们为什么想要更多的平静？
Otherwise, it's only thinking, only idea to have more of this and less of that.
或者我们就只是一直在思考哦， 想要这个不想要那个而已。
Is there ignorance at moment of seeing, not understanding the way it is, the truth of it?
在看的那一刻呢， 很快是不是我们都不知道有无明，不知道什么是在看？
Otherwise, there is no understanding of what ignorance is of what.
否则我们就不会真的知道所谓的无明是对什么无明。
So now, there is seeing, hearing, thinking. Does anyone want to have less ignorance?
比如现在在看，有在听，也有在想，有没有谁想要少一点无明呢？
And what moment is calm, so that one would like to have more?
那到底哪一刻才是有平静呢？所以我们会想要多一点呢？
At moment of understanding the truth of what is there, is that calm true?
那么在了解升起的那一刻的时候，那一刻有没有平静呢？
Does anyone would like to have calm and not just calm, calm from understanding, with understanding, any moment when there is understanding, is calm with understanding, not just ordinary, what you take for calm at all.
那么因为智慧升起的时候呢，一定会有平静嘛？所以是想要只要有平静吗？还是想要因为智慧升起所带来的平静？ 这个平静不是一般的平静，不是一般我们以为的平静呢。
At moment of ignorance, is it calm?
那么在无明的那一刻，有没有平静呢？会是平静的吗？
As calm cannot arise without conditions, nothing can arise without condition, and what conditions calm? When there is understanding, there is calm. So without understanding, it's not calm. And sometimes it can be calm without understanding. So what kind of calm would you like to have more?
那么平静呢，他的身体也是需要条件的哦。那智慧升起的时候呢，会有平静哦。那有时候平静的身体也不需要智慧，但是你想要哪一种平静呢？
So what kind of calm is really beneficial?
说哪一种平静才是非常有帮助的？
And so would you like, you say like to have more calm? It means that you like to have more calm with panya, right understanding.
所以你是不是想要因为智慧所带来的平静？
Is that true or not true?
这些是真的吗？还是不是真的？
At moment of wanting, just wanting to have less ignorance and more calm, is that moment calm? Can it lead to more calm, calmness?
在想要有更多的平静的时候，那个时刻会是平静吗？那个时刻会成为更多平静的条件吗？
That's why even ignorance and calm has to be known very well in order to really see the danger of it, to have less of it.
所以无明跟平静这两个不同的法必须要被清楚的认识哦。如果无明的危险没有被看到，那就不太有容易能够培养更多的平静，更少的无明。
It's not just wanting it.But not understanding it, it's impossible to have less ignorance when there's no understanding of it.
如果只是想要更少的无明，而不是了解什么是无明、无明的危险等等，现在的无明，那是不可能有更少的无明的。
So now, to be sincere, does anyone would like to have less ignorance?
所以我们现在很真诚、很诚实的哦。我们有没有希望少一点无明？
And the only way to have less ignorance is to understand more about ignorance. That is the way to have less ignorance.
所以要有更少的无明的条件就是更知道什么是无明。
Otherwise, how can there be less, even is now, and here is not known?
否则怎么可能会变得更少呢？即使他现在就在这里哦，他不知道，他没有被知道。
So it's there because of ignorance and because of ignorance on and on and on.
那为什么现在有无明呢？那是因为有无明，因为累积的无明一再的累积，一再的累积，一再的升起。
So to be truthful, Satya Bharami is important too.
所以诚实波罗蜜是很重要的哦，面对。
When there is panya, all kinds of kusala conditioned by panya is parami.
那么当智慧升起的时候呢，智慧会是所有的波罗蜜升起的因缘条件哦。
So in truth, before just wanting to have less ignorance, there must be the understanding of what is there now.To know whether it's ignorance or not.
所以要真的能够有更少的无明，它一定是因为智慧能够了解现在在那里的是什么，包括可能无明也被了解。
Just wanting to have less ignorance is not parami because there's no understanding of parami.
那么如果只是想要更少的无明，这个想要本身不可能是一个波罗蜜哦，不了解什么才是善的波罗蜜。
But when there is the understanding that right now, why there's no understanding of what is there as it is.
那么当然只有透过智慧哦，智慧一定是因为知道现在的真相，在那里的法的真相是什么。
And understand firmly that ignorance is there as long as there is no understanding of what is there.
那么我们也可以了解，当智慧没有升起的时候，是无明在那里哦。我们也可以知道这两个的区别，也越来越坚定的知道有信心。这个差别是没有智慧升起的时候，就是在无明里面。
So it's not just wanting this or that without understanding the truth. That's useless.
如果不知道真相，只是要这个不要那个，一点用都没有。
To really see the danger of ignorance can condition Bharami to be patient to understand and understand the truth. How much understanding of what we have heard and about what is there now when it's there now.
了解，如果真的了解无明的危险呢，它会是培养。比如说耐心波罗蜜的条件呢，会更有耐心，就知道这个危险，你会更有耐心，知道智慧的价值。
Otherwise, it's so very superficial to think that all dhammas are dhamma, not self. But what about now? Is it something? And what is the meaning of atta or self? Whatever is there as something is what is meant by atta, not anatta.
否则呢，就会只是在表面上，我们以为在讲诸法无我无我，但是那个我那个阿达那个人或东西到底是什么
？The understanding of the difference between atta and anatta is calm when it's there.
了解什么是 anatta 无我非我，跟什么是 atta 有一个人或东西的存在，了解这个的。真正的真相，平静就在那里哦。
It's calm because it's not the ignorance of that as taking it for something instantly as usual.
那么了解真相的时候，一定有平静哦，因为它不会像平常一样就立刻相信有个人或东西的存在。
So a moment of calm is different from a moment of ignorance.
所以。因为智慧带来的平静跟无明的那一刻一定是不同的。
Or are there in life from moment to moment? Ignorance or understanding, calm or no calm, wholesome or unwholesome.
所以生命这样一刻一刻过去哦，有平静还是没有平静，有智慧还是没有智慧。
The cause or the result at this very moment.Without understanding, it cannot be calm at all.
这个因缘条件每一刻都是这样子啊。如果没有真的智慧，那又怎么能够带来真正的平静
？So the opposite of calm is that one takes for a moment of being worried, agitated, and troubled, and so on. And the opposite of it is calm. It's not that at all.
所以平静是什么？它并不是那些担忧啊、烦恼的相反，并不是那些的相反就等于平静。
Even there's no trouble, no pain, no unpleasant moment, is it calm at that very moment without these trouble?
那么，即使是没有那些麻烦的事情啊、烦恼啊、担忧啊、恐惧，那就是平静吗？
The best of all conditioned reality is right understanding of the truth. So now, is it calm?
那么最好的、最珍贵的就是有智慧去了解真相哦。那么现在，所以现在有没有平静
？If there's still ignorance, no way to have less ignorance, not understanding whether this moment is calm or not calm.
如果没有智慧，真的了解，那这一刻有没有平静？什么是平静？那又怎么能够有更少的无明呢
？I think that this is an answer.
那老师说，这就是答案哦。刚刚提问的这个答案。
Is it beneficial to understand this moment when someone would like to have calm without understanding whether there is calm is impossible. But when there is the understanding of what is there, there can be moment of understanding, different moments of having calmness and no calmness at all.
那么老师的意思是，如果只是希望这一刻有平静，但是那种没有智慧的平静，它没有真正的帮助我。当智慧能够了解在那里的法是什么的真相的时候，当他可以了解有平静跟没有平静的差别的时候，这才是平静可以真正开始，培养的因缘条件了。
So what kind of calmness that one would like to have more? And what is that which is not known? And one would like to have more understanding of that and less ignorance of that.
所以会想要的是哪一种平静呢？没有智慧的还是有智慧带来的平静呢？那么那个不想要更多的，那个无明不想要更多，想要少一点，有真的对他有了解吗？
At moment of not understanding it, is it calm?
那么在没有了解的时候呢，有平静吗？
And when there is the understanding, is it not calm?
那么在了解的那一刻，难道没有平静吗？
Otherwise, what kind of calmness would you like to have more?
或者能不能分辨哪一种才是你希望要有的平静呢？
This is the subtlety of reality, even if there is not known, and that is condition for wishing, wanting to have something without understanding of the truth of it. So it's the ignorance. It can be less only when there is understanding of it little by little.
那这个也就是法的真相的深奥哦。那么因为不知道，所以就会成为想要这个不想要那个的一个因缘条件哦。那么也只有透过智慧的培养，在那里的真相，法的真相是什么，才能够真正的所谓的更少的无明，更多的偏见。
When there is the understanding that everything is gone, never to return.So this moment is not just last moment, previous moment ago. Even that moment is the calm.
如果在真的体会了解到现在法就在生灭哦，那么上一刻跟这一刻是不一样，这一刻又过去了。在真的这样子的了解的时候呢，这样的时刻有没有平静？
And the truth of it is, even that has gone.But there is the thinking of something without understanding. So where is calm? Right understanding begin to understand the moments of akusa and wholesomeness. It's not moment of calmness.
那即使是现在一直在生灭哦，法一直在过去，但是我们会去想着，一些概念，那我们不知道真相是什么。那在这种状况下呢，当然就不知道什么是真正的平静了。我们也不见得真正分别的出什么是善，什么是不善。
And this is the subtlety of all dharmas. Even if there is not known, and when it's gone, it's not known.
那么，这就是为什么我们说法是深奥的哦。它在那里，即使它灭去了，我们一直都不知道。我们嘴巴里面讲，但是它，我们不是真的知道。
But it can be developed, it can be understood little by little, and that is part of me, to be patient, to understand the truth, the subtlety of all dharmas now appearing unknown, to be known little by little.
这也是为什么需要耐心波罗蜜哦，耐心波罗蜜是一个必要的条件哦，对于智慧的培养是一点一点的有耐心的慢慢的去了解。
Is that the way to have less ignorance?Can there be other way?
那么有其他的方式可以有更少的无明吗？
At moment of wanting without understanding, is it calm and less ignorance? Impossible.
在想要的那一刻就可以有更多的平静跟更少的无明吗？这是不可能的。
So begin to understand the truth of itSubtlety of all dharmas, which appears from life to life unknown because of its subtlety.
那么开始智慧开始慢慢去了解这些法的深奥哦，那它就在那里，可是它都没有被知道。
And to be truthful, Sajja Bharami is so very important that it can condition more chanda to understand the truth. even so very, very difficult to understand.
这就是为什么诚实波罗蜜很重要，我们对这个实际的状况是诚实的、真实的，那这会成为善欲的因缘条件呢、哦？有兴趣的因缘条件。
Even the truth is now at this very moment, but it's so deep and so far to understand the way it is.
虽然真相现在每一刻就在那里哦，但是它是这么的深，又离那么远啊、哦，我们没有办法真的知道。
But the understanding of the word of truth from the enlightened one, conditioned moment of getting closer and closer and closer to understand what is there now. Openadiko, santitiko, akaliko.
那佛陀的话呢，就是帮助我们如理作业的话，更接近、更靠近这个法。Ajahn, could you say that the last three, the Pali word, the, what's the、English? Or?
Kunsara can help anyone to understand what is meant by the word Opanaiko, Santitiko, Agaliko. What would the term?
Santitiko.Akaliko, Ehipasiko. These are epithets to describe the Dhamma taught by the Buddha.
那么刚刚提到的有三个巴利文呢，它是不同的面向来描述法。
Akaliko means not time limited.
那第一个巴利文呢，是指没有时间的限制，是恒久正确的。
That is to say, valid for all times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And ahipassiko means for to be experienced each person by themselves, to be experienced by each person for him or herself.
那这个法的第一个刚刚提到的是永恒的真相不会变的、哦、那它是第二个是指它必须
Sorry, I got that wrong. It means inviting one to come and see. Ahipasiko, inviting to be understood, to be explored and appreciated.
那么第一个巴利文指的是佛陀讲他的真相，讲他发现的真相是什么？他邀请我们来了解。
So in short, the teaching of the Dhamma is the truths of the Dhamma are valid for all times, for all beings, and are capable of being understood by individuals.Who can appreciate their truth?
所以刚刚那三个巴利文其实它的意思就是说，佛陀邀请我们来了解真相是什么。这个真相是永恒不变的，不会随着时间改变的。那这个真相是必须每个人，它是可以被了解的，这是每个人是自己去了解。佛陀没有办法替你了解。
And to open eye go leading to the goal.
那另外那个巴利文呢，就是能够带领向体验真相哦，领悟真相是什么
？Because they are now ready a time to be known that it's not far away from what is there now, so very close but so very deep and subtle that it takes quite a long time or parami to support to have chanda interest.To see the benefit of the teachings, the most precious thing is understanding what is there while one is there.
那法的真相很深奥，好像离我们很远，可它事实上它又在现在这里，只是真的要接近，接近，越来越接近，是需要慢慢慢慢的累积的哦。
So it's not right standing of seeing somewhere, but it's now at moment of seeing. Open adiko, just now, so close, coming back to what is there now, not go further far away.
所以第一个就是不用去很远的，不用去哪里找，它就在现在这里，它就在这里，所以我们回到这里，法就在现在这里哦。
If it's not there, it cannot be understood, it cannot be discerned, but it's there to be known little by little.
如果法现在不在这里，又怎么如何能够了解它呢？它要如何能够被知道呢？只是这个了解要一点一点的累积。
Sanditiko visible can be understood now.
好，那他们是可以被看见的，不是指眼睛看见的，智慧可以看到的，他们是可以被了解的。
So sanditiko, akaliko, ahipasiko, openaiko,
and pajjatan.
Pajjatan.